guess we'll get started. I was hoping more people come to this, but I guess they know more people like y'all than they do me. I don't know, a lot of people don't like me. But anyway, 11 years ago today, we started doing this. 11 years ago today, we had our first one. And we wanted to do something every other year to recognize some of the people that, you know, play with, have been faithful to I say. COVID messed us up, that's why we're on an odd year, but me and Derek put a lot of thought into all this, and he's a talker, and he's going to take over here and say, but I appreciate all y'all coming, and after your presenter introduces you, then you come up, then we'll give you out the stuff and take a picture, and then afterward we'll take more pictures. All right, thank y'all.
I do want to thank everybody for coming. Take all the pictures you want, but please, if you haven't already, turn your fingers off. You need to take all the pictures, but you won't see me and mine, Reggie, Wendell, and collared shirts and ties very often, so you better record it. But Mike and I started working together in 2002 with ISA, and like you said, it's the 11th year that we've done our State Hall of Fame. And we want a way to show our appreciation to the people that support our company and that are loyal to us. And I know everybody plays a lot of different things, but it just seems like every weekend that we're here in Cherokee or Cullowhee or somewhere, you guys are there. And it's a way of showing our appreciation to you. Something a little above and beyond, you know, winning something that tournament. It's a little something a little special. And I said it in the past, don't let the size of the crowd take away from the importance of what's happened. You don't need a big crowd to make it special. And I know it was to me. I know it was to Jake. It was to Mike. And all the other Hall of Fame members that we've been inducted over the years. They're actually listed inside the pamphlet. And a lot of you have asked, how do we nominate people? Well, Mike and I, once somebody gives us a name, we'll talk it over. But basically what we look for is, like I said, people that are loyal to us, that are that play with us, players who excel, win, attitude, and coaches and sponsors that support us and that are there week in and week out. So if you got people that fall into that criteria, by all means, you know, give us their name. And we'll talk about it, and you know, 2 years from now, we'll see who that class is. But let me be the first to say congratulations to the three going in today. Well deserved, all the way around. All y'all guys are class acts, good ball players, and good people. So congratulations. And with that, I'll turn it over to our first inductor of the night.
Mike, you and Derek, appreciate what you're doing for these guys. This is special. All of you, I've had the opportunity to play with most of you in this room, which is pretty big. I wasn't around and I hadn't been around in a while. But it's good to see a lot of you. And congratulations to everybody that's going to be inducted. It's a special moment. I'm here to introduce Chad King. Chad and I played together forever. When we were playing in ISA League in Waynesville, we sat down as a group, and there were 11 of us sat down as that group, and decided we wanted to go to the next level. And Chad said, look, if we want to do it, let's do it all. And let's all be in. And so we did as a group. And Chad, he footed the bill for it. Let's just go ahead and call it what it is. He footed the bill and took care of us. And he made sure everything was up and running. And we were there. It was a lot of days riding cars, a lot of trips all over the country. And we had a good time. I can distinctly remember. scrap the new phone and shut it down and get that old long-wheelbase Ford truck that looked like it was a dog tracking down the road. And we went to play, and somebody borrowed his truck, and the truck was gone for half the tournament. Didn't know how he was going to get back home. And, you know, just the dumb stuff that we all go through and do. We've all got stories. We've all got stories and all this stuff. When we won our first world together, that was special. A lot of state tournaments, a lot of super world stuff that we did together. But through it all, Chad was the guy. He was the one keeping it together. He was putting the money out and making it happen. And, you know, don't know that we ever said it, but on behalf of the other 10 people, Chad, we do appreciate what you did. Yeah. It means a lot, because it allowed us to do what we love to do, and you did it with us. And so, by all means, you deserve this, and I'm proud of you. Come on, let's go.
Spent a lot of time on the road. Won a lot of stuff. But the only thing I miss most is the people, the ball players. That's where it is. Yes. If I could do it all over again, I'd do it. And that we're all too old. But anyway, I appreciate it. Pisses me off sometimes because most, I'll
five of the group.
Right.
Reggie called me, man, Jake. I said, look here, brother. You put all this stuff on Facebook, you're quiet. Because my dad said, recruit as many haters as you can, because the haters are going to talk about you. Your friends are not. Right? So that's one thing. So Reggie has played on team, he has coached team, but he's always had his team. And a lot of people don't understand what RBI stands for. It's Reggie Bone Incorporated. Did y'all know that? Okay, so now you know. I just thought that his acumen for softball is a will of reproach. The guy knows the game. He knows the game of softball. And I can go on and on about this dude. We done been on teams. We done been enemies. Believe it or not, we have been enemies. I know people always ask me, how did they go? Connected at the hip. Not always. So it's my honor to introduce to you guys my guy, Mr. Allen Reggie Bone Ledbetter. And I'm going to give him this big piece of chicken because he deserves this. Man, I love you. Come on.
Maybe
our last induction of the day. Once again, Mr. J. Craig.
All right. That's the third one.
Once upon a time, no. It's a way back. Mr. Wendell Fortner, a lot of people wouldn't realize that me and him are the same. It's funny to say it, but Wendell, back in the day, was a family man. And he loved to go to tournaments and he loved to invite people out to his house, right? And I was one of those guys that was fortunate enough to go to his house. And we just out there messing around. Anything can kick off. That was wrestling. We're doing a bunch of stuff, right? Other than softball. So me and him always made a pact to say, whenever we're playing on a team or we're playing against the team, it's not being attentive to the game. It's how you calm your nerves and get past all the chaos on the softball field, right? So that's what me and Wendell did. So a lot of you guys don't know, because you know Wendell's a competitive player. He's a family Wendell, and he's a softball Wendell. And he separates those pretty well. So we're here today to talk about the softball Wendell. And like me, he's a fierce competitor. Wendell has all the accolades. He's an immense player. He done battled on some teams. He's been at the top of his line. And the last tournament, me and him had a conversation. And we was talking about senior ball. I'm 60. So he always asked me, "Hey Jay, why don't you like playing senior ball?" I think senior ball is slow, but Wendell is his game because he's a pitcher, and I know if everybody in here was a pitcher, they know senior ball you hit with a senior bat. That man right there can protect his own self, right, at his age. So I just want to tell Wendell and Reggie, it's been my sincere honor to know you guys and have played with you guys and still friends. So again, it's my honor. Let me go back here. In lieu of our battles, Wendell, you have stayed true as a friend to me and to softball. So it's my honor to introduce my friend, again, Mr. Wendell Fortner, to you guys. Love you, bro.
In this area, and thank you all.
some pictures at home when Ben Wendell and Harold and Chad lost it still skiing, but when the rest of us was skiing. Even JC, we weren't big when we started playing levels. We are now. I'm gonna post them on Facebook for everybody to see them.
We really was skiing. That's not necessary.
No, it's necessary. I like to see myself.
Congratulations, all you guys. And you know, the common theme wasn't softball today. Common theme was relationships. That's what it's about. You don't miss the seven games in 98-degree heat in August. You don't miss sliding into second and tearing all the skin off the side of your leg. And you sure don't miss getting line drives hit at you, do you? But when you don't play, you miss the people. So that's what it's all about. But thank everybody for being here. We appreciate it. And everybody be safe on your way home. And if you want to hang around, take some pictures, by all means, let's take pictures. Thank you.